Gotta find the exact location, which is kind of tricky to find, but oh, there is something right here. So one of you guys told me to check out the Balleny Islands, which are way under New Zealand, really close to Antarctica. However, when I was zooming in, I couldn't help but notice this little island way on its own over here. So this video is not going to be about the Balleny Islands, but instead about the journey of figuring out what this thing is, if it's even a real island, and if there's anything there. So the first thing I'm noticing about this island is it's way on its own, and there just seems to be nothing around it besides a lot of the coast of Antarctica. Also, when you zoom into this thing, the resolution never actually increases, and it appears just as blurry zoomed in as when you're zoomed all the way out. When you click on the island, it just says unavailable on the bottom, which is really weird because almost every island in the world, no matter how remote and uninhabited and unknown it is, always says something. For example, coming up near Canada, if I just click on a random island like this one, it has a name. So if Google doesn't have a name for it, then I guess for now, we're just gonna have to call it Unavailable Island. So let's look at some other satellite mapping services and see if anything else has this island on their map. So as you've probably seen in my other videos, Apple Maps shows really far north places with a lot higher resolution than Google Maps. So let's see if it's the same in the Southern Hemisphere. So when I'm zooming into that same area, I can't seem to see anything, but maybe it just pops up when I zoom in really far. There possibly is something right here. It does seem that Apple Maps wants to show it as land possibly, or maybe it's a big ravine of some sort in the ocean. There's also a few bumps in the ocean up here, but zooming in on these doesn't show any land as well. So Apple Maps is not going to give us our answer. Let's try Mapcarta. So we're in Mapcarta, let's look at that same area. Let's see if we can even see those Balleny Islands first. They don't really show up until you zoom in, but there they are. Let's go over to that same area that Unavailable Island is in. Not seeing anything yet. Yeah, there doesn't seem to be anything on Mapcarta's map, and there's no place names for this thing either. Let's try Google Earth. So I'm on Google Earth, and we just gotta rotate back the right way. So zooming to that same area, you can see that same structure, which makes sense. It's on Google Earth and Google Maps, but it doesn't have any additional information on this place. Let's see if historical imagery will show anything. So as soon as I click on historical imagery, this thing just disappears and never seems to pop up a single time going all the way back to the 1985. So something is up with this location. There's got to be some secret here, or maybe it's just some error in the mapping. Let's try one more thing to see if we can find any information on this. So I about gave up on this video, but then I tried to use Wikimapia, which is actually a really good tool for these remote uninhabited islands, because if you zoom in, like let's go to the Balleny Islands for example, you can see that it shows Buckle Island, and you can click on it, gives it a lot of information, and will link it to a lot of different websites. So let's see if we can see that same thing with Unavailable Island. Gotta find the exact location, which is kind of tricky to find, but oh, there is something right here. Okay. It's labeled as Spirit Island. And when you zoom in, it doesn't seem like there's anything else, and the coordinates do match up to the right place. So let's click on it and see what it says. All right, so it's a Spirit Island, part of Antarctica, sector claimed by France. I'm not even going to try to pronounce this, but permanent station of France. It's a mysterious island that remains undocumented and unrecognized. Presumably, it's a massive iceberg. Nearby cities, nothing. And that's all the information. It doesn't even link to a Wikipedia page. So let's see if we can just search Spirit Island and see what comes up. So all of the links when you search Spirit Island just goes to some board game with its same name. But it does seem like on these pictures, there is some island named Spirit Island. So let's look at pictures next. Okay, a lot of these pictures say Spirit Island in Canada in Jasper National Park. But that is clearly not the same island, and obviously it's not in Canada. Let's try searching with the words Antarctica on it. Well, we get Spurt Island, but that is not the right one. Some more stuff about Spirit of Shackleton Antarctic Cruises. Nothing about this unknown island. So now we gotta try a little harder to find out what's going on. So when I was researching my video on the mysterious structure in the Russian Arctic, it was really helpful to find out what the name of these capes were. because then I can more easily locate what's going on all these capes and find out what the different buildings are. So let's try the same thing with Unavailable Island way down here. We got to figure out what these capes are and see if there's any islands near them. So I looked up a detailed map of Antarctica, and I'm going to zoom in right on the area where that Unavailable Island is. Here are those Balleny Islands, and this is about where that Unavailable Island is, 66 south and 150 east. But it doesn't show anything on this map where it does show the Balleny Islands. So I'm starting to think that broken off glacier theory is true. So I wonder if anyone's found this glacier before or documented it, because it seems like it was pretty big. And I find it hard to believe that no one noticed a large glacier floating through the sea, but it's possible. So let's search if we can find that. So I found this article from Science Daily, which says large iceberg breaks off Antarctica's Mertz Glacier, written in 2010. In summary, they saw the calving event of a large iceberg from the Mertz Glacier, which is really close to where Unavailable Island is. And they noted that this iceberg is 78 kilometers long with 2,500 square kilometers, about the size of Luxembourg. It was broke off after being rammed by another iceberg. I highly recommend you look up videos of glaciers calving because it is the coolest thing to see on a video. There are some glaciers that, just like this one, are absolutely massive, and to see it on a scale like that, just all breaking off, is pretty wild to look at. But let's see if Unavailable Island fits the parameters of this 78 kilometer long structure. So orienting ourselves, this is Unavailable Island, and this right here is the Mertz Glacier, and this thing is absolutely massive. You can see on Google Maps just how far this thing extends into Antarctica. This thing is constantly moving and sending off huge icebergs into the ocean. If you zoom in at the very end of it, you can see multiple smaller icebergs just breaking off and setting free into the ocean, where they're eventually going to melt as they go farther up north. You can easily see how there's much larger chunks like this one right here that could just all come off at once and possibly become something like this Unavailable Island up here. I mean, Unavailable Island is not a lot bigger than a lot of these ice chunks that you see right around the Mertz Glacier. Now, when you measure it, it's only about 9 kilometers long, so it's nowhere near the length of the iceberg from the article that we read. But it does seem to fit in with a lot of the size of the glaciers that come off of Antarctica. So I guess the answer is, yeah, Unavailable Island is probably not actually an island, but more likely a iceberg from a glacier, probably Mertz Glacier, but somewhere around in Antarctica that broke off, moved through the ocean, and Google Maps just happened to snap a pic of it at the right time and thought it was an island, but was just never corrected. And I assume sometime in the future, this will disappear as new satellite imagery of this place comes about. Now, if you guys have any other ideas about this island, please let me know down in the comments. And if you have any other suggestions for possible places to look into, please leave it down in the comments. I read everything down there. And I think I want to do a longer video where I kind of look at a bunch of people's comments and quickly go over a bunch of different locations. So I'm going to make a big compilation in the future. If you liked this video, you probably liked this video in the bottom left corner. Also, make sure to hit subscribe. Thanks.